Hey everyone, this is a demonstration video for a Pioneer RT707. This is a reel-to-reel direct drive auto reverse tape deck. These were super popular when they came out. There were a bunch sold because they're just so awesome. They're great decks. The transport is super smooth. Very well built, very popular with the audiophiles. I'm just going to go ahead and record some music here with it real quick. Just a quick background. I got the set in estate sale and I gave it to my tech. He replaced the only belt in this machine, which is the counter belt. Everything else is motor driven direct drive. So replaced that belt, replaced the VU meter lights, replaced the record light, and replaced the direction lights for the auto reverse. So greased up some parts in it, and it seems to be functioning really well. You know, these are really good machines, but let's go ahead and record something real quick, and then we'll go through the various functions. I'm sure you'll recognize the music, maybe not, but here we go. Listening to right now is the tape. If you press this button right here, you're listening to the source. So that's the source coming in from the CD, and this is actually what's being recorded. Go ahead and stop it, and we'll bring it back to the zero marker. As you can see, the counter works. So I'll just go over real quick, and this has got a really pretty quick, fast rewind. The rewind is pretty solid on this machine. I'll just go over real quick and let you know what I've tested. The mic inputs work, the line inputs work, the phone works, the headphones inputs work, the speed functions work, the tape and source functions work. The bias and the EQ switch, I've messed with these a little bit, depending upon what tape you've got. This is a really old tape, so I think this setting here is good for that. The record mode functions work. The auto reverse works. The pitch control works. Pretty much everything I've tested on this machine works great. So it's in pretty good working condition. I'd say, you know, cosmetically, I'd give it 8.5, you know, or so out of 10. It's got some marks up on top. I think it was sitting for a while with gear on top of it. So a couple of, you know, small little corrosion marks up top and one in the back. But the faceplate is, you know, mint. So let's go ahead and play back the music and let's see how it sounds recorded. And we'll mess with some of the functions too when I play it back. Watching me. records and plays back, you know, really good. So the pitch control works. So as you can see, that works. The speed function works. Wow, that's real interesting. So you can see that works. The counter works. So the auto reverse function works. Got nothing recorded on this side. Oh, well, there we go. There is something recorded on this side. It's an old tape. So that was probably recorded at this speed. Well, that's a bell choir. Wow. That's pretty cool, actually. Wow. So, yeah, the auto reverse works. Let's get it back on Super Tramp. Just so you can see it in fast forward mode, it fast forwards and rewinds great. Let's go ahead and rewind it. As you can see, it's in pretty good condition. I mean, it's working good. It's playing fine. It's recording in both directions. The pause function works. Everything's working really good on this machine. Plus, it looks really good. Just a great machine in really good working condition. You know, just serviced. Reel-to-reel tape machines that are, you know, this old, you know, it's a good idea to do these videos just to kind of show people what they're buying, the condition that it's in. But just great machine, really beautiful. If I didn't have a Studer deck and a Revox deck, you know, I would keep this machine. It is probably one of the best 7-inch machines out there. Just really solid. But anyways, thanks for watching.